Hi guys, I'm Sarah from Somatic Movement Center. I get a lot of questions about how tight muscles cause idiopathic scoliosis. Scoliotic curves are unique to every person, and they usually involve both lateral curvature and rotation. In this video, I'm going to keep it really simple and just talk about how chronic muscle contraction creates a lateral C curve in the spine. First, let's look at what happens when a muscle does a concentric contraction. The muscle fibers get shorter, so the whole muscle gets shorter. Skeletal muscles are attached to bones on either end by their tendons, so when a muscle contracts and gets shorter, these bones are brought closer together. I know that seems really obvious, but there's a lot of talk about weak muscles in scoliosis, and it's not really accurate, and I'm going to show you why. Like I said before, everyone's curvature is different. I'm using this x-ray because it clearly illustrates some points that I want to make. This x-ray was taken from the front, but I flipped it around so that we can talk about the right and left sides more easily. So this is a fairly straightforward C curve. It's concave on the right and convex on the left. While you're watching this, I want you to try to create this curve in your spine. You can do this sitting down or standing up. Slowly make the curve, and then slowly release back to a neutral spine. Notice what muscles are contracting to create the curve. You might have to do this a few times to really notice. Muscles on the right side of your waist will contract to bring you into the curve, and then you'll feel them release as you come out of it. Those muscles on the side of your waist are your obliques. They bend your spine to the side and also rotate your spine. So in this woman's x-ray, we can tell that her obliques on her right side are tight because of the direction and location of her curve. There are other muscles involved too, but the obliques are the strong core muscles that are pulling her ribcage and pelvis toward each other. You can see the distance between her bottom rib and the top of her pelvis is shorter on her right side because her obliques are contracted. You can also see that her right hip is hiked up a little higher than her left, so she has functional leg length discrepancy. So some people say that the muscles on the concave side of the curve are weak, but they're actually chronically contracted, and over time the contraction of these muscles becomes so deeply learned by the nervous system that the person totally loses voluntary control of the muscles. They're basically frozen in a contracted state, so they're not weak by any means. The person has just lost the ability to voluntarily contract and release them. Now, here's the conundrum. Scoliosis can be so confusing because people usually feel a lot of painful muscle tension on the opposite side of the curve, the convex side, and here's why. If you bend to the right for just a minute, like you did when you tried to create this curve in your spine, the muscles on the left side of your torso are stretched and lengthened. But if you stay bent over to the right and never come back up, your nervous system will automatically contract the muscles on the left side of your torso to try to pull you up straight so that you don't fall over. So in this example, as this woman's right side obliques became tighter and tighter, increasing her curve, the muscles on her left side had to continue to work harder and harder to keep her standing upright. So if your curvature is similar to this, muscles on both sides of your curve are tight, but you probably feel painful tension in the muscles on the convex side of your curve, because the muscles on that side are being stretched at the same time as being contracted. The tight obliques on the right side are pulling the spine into the curve and stretching the muscles on the left side, but those left side muscles can never stop working because if they do, you'll fall over. Stretching a tight muscle is painful, and it's happening constantly in scoliosis. So the muscles are tight on both sides of scoliotic curves, just in different ways. You need to release the muscles on both sides of the curve in order to let the spine straighten out. In most cases, it's most effective to start by releasing the tight muscles on the concave side of the curve. These muscles are, in most cases, what initially cause the curve. You won't make much progress if you just focus on releasing the tight muscles on the convex side, because the muscles on the concave side will still be tight, still creating the curve. Traditional stretching and strengthening exercises usually don't accomplish much when you're trying to straighten a scoliotic curve, because they don't change the messages that the brain is sending to the muscles to stay tight, and they don't have a lasting effect on the baseline level of muscle tension being set by the nervous system. Pandiculation is the most effective way to retrain the nervous system in these ways. If you want to learn more, read The Pain Relief Secret and check out the Scoliosis course on somaticmovementcenter.com. Thanks for watching!